Are you getting bored of doing the same old straight air on every jump? In this video, I'll teach you how to whip your mountain bike like a pro. Hey guys, Reggie here with Adventure Sport U, and today I'll be breaking down the mechanics of the whip step by step. On this channel, we bring you adventure sports tutorials, so if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you can see more videos like this. You can also sign up to be notified for the launch of the Mountain Biking Masterclass, where we'll be diving into all the topics, including bikes, gear, techniques, and more. Link is in the description down below. Now, before I get started, I do want to point out that within the world of whips, there's lots of variation in technique and style based on the type of riding you'll be doing. For example, downhill racers will stay low while scrubbing a jump to maintain maximum speed on the course. In contrast, slopestyle riders will pop high and go for maximum amplitude and flare, which earns them higher scores from the judges. In short, there's no right or wrong way to do a whip, and the methods I'll be teaching in this lesson are just the way that I learned to do whips. All right, no more wasting time, let's get started. So for starters, you'll need to be comfortable riding table jumps with a proper lip. You don't need a huge jump, but having a proper lip will ensure that you get enough amplitude to bring your rear wheel back for a straight landing. The pump track is a great place to condition your aerial awareness, so if you're not quite there yet, put in a few laps each day until you're at the point where you can flow through the jumps smoothly and confidently. You can whip your bike on jumps with a flat takeoff, but it's harder to bring your wheel back and land smoothly, so I wouldn't recommend it. Once you have your jumping skills dialed, for the second step in the progression, we'll stay on the ground and practice our cutties. If you've already got this skill down, then great, go ahead and skip forward to the next section. The cutty is a technique in which a rider changes directions quickly on the trail by shifting their body weight, but without applying any brakes. It's important to point out the distinction between doing a cutty and skidding because A, skidding will cause you to lose all your speed, and B, skidding damages the trails and is frowned upon by the trail builders and the community, hence the term ride it, don't slide it. Now, that isn't to say that doing a cutty won't damage trails, nor would I make the case that skilled mountain bikers never lock up their rear brake out on the trail. The point is, know the difference between a skid and a cutty and be mindful of your impact on the trails. All right, enough of the rant, let's talk about how to execute a good cutty. The best place to start out is on a fire road or any off-road surface that isn't a maintained trail. Ideally, you'll slide into something that'll catch your rear wheel. Otherwise, you might just keep sliding and land on your butt. To perform a cutty, imagine your body as a spring. Load up your weight by twisting your body in the opposite direction you'll be going, and when you're ready to change directions, snap your arms and unload your body weight into the rear wheel. Two main things to point out here. One, use your arms to initiate the turning motion. Two, your feet will do a little crank flip as you unload and redistribute your weight to the opposite side. All right, now that you're able to put down a solid cutty, let's head back to the pump track. Now that you've got a jump in front of you, imagine that you're going to do a cutty on the face of the jump right as you're beginning to leave the lip. That being said, a good whip starts with the approach. When approaching the jump, try to pick a line opposite to the corner from which you'll be taking off. Imagine you'll be drawing a curve or a line on the jump as you move from one side to the other. This change in direction will help you initiate the motion that'll smoothly bring your back end around. When I first started whipping, I never would consider the approach and would take jumps straight, trying to turn my body midair. Aside from looking a bit forced, this method also caused my head to turn sideways, which is dangerous because it takes your eyes off the landing. So you should be already loading up your body weight and initiating the turn during your approach. But once your front wheel leaves the lip, that's when you can start doing your cutty, which will bring your rear wheel sideways. Twist your arms in order to keep the front wheel straight and lined up with the landing. Also keep your head facing forward with your eyes locked on the landing. After you've hit the apex of your jump, you'll want to begin straightening out your rear wheel, tapping your front wheel first and allowing your body to follow. All right, before you go, let's summarize the key points of this lesson. 1. Get comfortable doing table jumps with a decent lip. 2. Practice cutties on the ground and get your body familiar with loading and unloading your weight into the rear wheel. 3. Set yourself up in the approach by carving across the face of the jump. 4. Initiate the whip by doing a cutty when your front wheel leaves the jump. 5. Keep your head straight and eyes locked forward on the landing. 6. straighten out your rear wheel and land lightly with your front wheel first. So those are the key points to doing a whip, and I hope you found this lesson useful to break it down into those smaller steps. Just remember that we all started somewhere, and being comfortable in the air is a skill that requires time and patience. There's endless room for improvement with the whip, and mine are still definitely a work in progress. But I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and if you did, be sure to give it a thumbs up, ask your questions in the comments, and subscribe to the channel so you don't miss any new adventure sports tutorials. And again, if you want to sign up to be notified for the launch of the Mountain Biking Masterclass, where we'll dive into all the topics, including bikes, gear, technique, and more, then check out the link down below. All right, well, that's it for me, guys. If you have any further questions, please let me know.